Hello, my name is Chuck. I'm with Midwest Energy and Communications, and today I would like to explain to you some of our equipment. This right here is our standard installation for anybody who has our fiber service. We have a fiber router, and we have a battery backup. I'd like to tell you a little bit about these devices, and then I would also like to let you know how to perform a proper power cycle. So let's talk first about some of these lights. So on the battery backup, you should see one green light. That means it's functional. Then on the router itself, there's a little bit more action. The first thing you should notice, all green is all good. The top light is the power light. As long as that's solid green, that means it's getting power from the battery backup. The next light is the broadband light. That detects your actual connection to the fiber optic network. Next, we have the service light. That should be blinking all the time green, which means you have service. The next two that blink may not blink for you. What it is the Wi-Fi antennas that are on in this device. And then the following lights may be on or off and blinking for you. They correspond to the Ethernet and the phone ports located in the back of the router. So as long as they're all green or not on at the bottom, you'll be good. Now, one thing that this equipment does is if you lose power, then the battery backup provides juice to the router. So occasionally, if you have to power cycle the unit, simply unplugging the power cable from the wall will just result in this device beeping at you, and this won't actually turn off. So what I'd like to do is explain how to do a proper power cycle. Now, located in the back of the router, there should be some cables. There may not be any up here. If there are some up there for you, it's important that you don't move those because we don't want to rearrange the order of those. However, there is a large black cable coming from the battery backup. Now, there's a small tab on the other side of this cable. What you do is you pinch the tab and remove the cable. As soon as you do that, you should notice all of the lights go off. That's good. That means you definitely removed the power. Once it's off for about 30 seconds, what you have to do is you have to carefully fit the pins back in the sockets. And as soon as you plug it in, you should see the unit begin to boot. At this time, red is good. That means it's powering up. After 3 to 5 minutes, all the lights should be on as normal. Just like changing your oil in a car, doing a power cycle on any sort of electronic equipment is really important just to make sure that it works well. So I recommend that you perform a power cycle roughly once a month. Thank you so much. If you have any questions or you'd like further tech support, please reach us at 1-800-492-5989.